Hey humans, what's up? I'm Brianne Williamson. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If it's your first time here, make sure that you're subscribed. If it's not your first time here, double check that you're subscribed. This series that I've been doing is reacting to TikTok videos, specifically in the lesbian TikTok realm. It is 100% just for fun. I make zero money on this. They all get demonetized because of the TikTok music. So I really appreciate your support in the form of subscribing, giving this video a big thumbs up, and letting me know in the comments down below. It means a lot. Also, if you share it on social media with your friends, that would mean a lot too. I'll keep doing it as long as you all like it, because that's why I make these videos, for entertainment for all of you. I think we all need a laugh in 2020. So that's why I decided to jump on this TikTok React bandwagon. Speaking of TikTok, I'm over on TikTok at Brianne Williamson _. We have over 130,000 followers over there. You humans are so cool supporting me on all my platforms. You can also check me out on YouTube at Brianne Williamson. It means a lot and helps me to be able to continue to create queer content. So thanks for the support. Let's jump in, shall we? All right, so if you've watched the last two videos, you know that I reacted to #lesbianthirsttrap as well as #lesbiantiktok. Today, we are reacting to #cutelesbiancouples. I'll be the judge of whether or not these lesbian couples are cute, okay? I'm just kidding. Any couple that's putting themselves out there and creating free content for the world to enjoy, having fun doing it, feeling confident, I think it's amazing. So do not take any of my opinions today as hate. I'm just reacting for fun. It's just for a laugh, but I am gonna be honest. Prepare to be disgusted by how adorable these couples are. I hope, or cringy.
One of the best feelings is finding someone who really gets you. Someone who never tells you that you're too much of this or too little of that. Because to them, you're just enough of everything they love.
Okay, I realize that one of the clips overshadowed the rest of my views on this video, because in general, it was cute. I just can't get past the smoke coming out of the nostrils. Anyone else, like when I watch this, I'm not like, that's so cute. I'm thinking in my head, why did they include a clip of smoke coming out of their nostrils? That was one of the cutest clips they have. They included it in this. It's just not it for me. I don't know. I guess some people these days think that is attractive or adorable or something. Let's move on, shall we?
There's a place where hearts go to cry their troubles away.
Okay, that made my whole day. Like, I'm about to get sappy now, but there's something about throwback LGBTQ plus couples that just warms my damn heart. My cold, cold heart has been warmed. That was adorable. In fact, I'm gonna like that. Liked.
I love you for infinity.
Oh, oh, oh. Aww. Okay, I loved that because, first of all, the jump was great because they really launched onto their partner. Loved that. Second, and probably my favorite part, is that the partner didn't just put them down afterwards. They just kept walking with their little suitcase while they were still koala'd. That was so cute. I loved that.
I wanted to run away with you.
Okay, I know. What's the word? Am I a cynic? Am I a critic? All of the above? I'm cynical. I don't know what word I'm looking for. I just can't handle, and I fully expected to see a little bit of it. I can't handle the videos that are so obviously planned. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this person just happened to be recording and they said that. I'm in my happy place now. Because I know couples do say that to each other. But I'm just like, what are the odds that that person doesn't know that their partner is recording and they have the phone up and they just say that? Like, That would just never happen in my relationship. We'd say it, but as soon as we know the camera's on, we'd either be doing it for the camera or not at all because the camera's on. And then we'd be like kind of embarrassed and not totally in the moment. I don't know. I don't buy it. Let me know in the comments if you buy it. If you think these types of couple videos are just genuine, or if you're on team cold heart over here.
Knowing nothing in life, but I gotta get rich. You could check.
Shut the fuck up. I'm a hot girl. I do hot shit. The fact that I did not expect that genuinely shocked me. How far down is this? We are killing it. So this is me and my girlfriend Julia on hashtag cute lesbian couples. But it's weird because in the hashtag, I don't even see that. We hashtag lesbian couple goals and hashtag lesbian couple, but I don't think I even hashtag cute lesbian couples. How am I like number five or whatever it is? I genuinely did not look or see who was on this. I just start from the top when I search a hashtag and scroll. So the fact that we popped up, genuinely shocked. Cool. Thanks for the love. Clearly got us that clout by all your support. Now that I'm not as shocked, let's watch this again. And I'm going to try and be non-biased in my review.
Life, but I gotta get rich. You could check your throwback pics up in that bitch. I'm a hot girl. I do hot shit.
Okay, so story behind this post is that Julia and I were away. We went on a road trip this summer to the Okanagan. And we went for some drinks and at this like outdoor beach bar. It was really fun. We had quite a few drinks. And then we walked back to the place we were staying. And afterwards, so Julia and I were walking back a little tipsy. I don't know how relatable this is to anyone watching, but you know when you're out with friends or your partner or whatever, and you have a few drinks and you're thinking you're looking really cute or you're gonna be able to take cute photos or it's gonna be like fun memories. And then you look at the photos the next day and you're like, what the actual hell did we take? And why do we think these were fun or cute photos? So we woke up the next day, we had such a fun night. And I looked through the photos of my phone because I was genuinely like, maybe I'll Instagram one of those photos from last night. And I scrolled through, no joke, maybe like 50 photos, all blurry, just like train wrecks. But we had a lot of fun, but I thought it was funny. So I made a little TikTok out of it of that kind of moment in life. Clearly people related. All right, well, I think that's a fair place to wrap it up. I'm a little rattled. I was not expecting to react to myself genuinely. Wow, thank you for the clout. I'm showing up at the top of these hashtag searches. I have officially made it, mom. Autographs to any distant family members will be available by order. If you want an autograph, mom and dad, please get in line. Just kidding. But yeah, that was fun to show up. If you aren't already, you can follow me on TikTok at @BrianneWilliamson_. As mentioned, we have over 130 humans over there. I post every single damn day, usually a few times a day. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button and let me know down below if you want to see more of these TikTok reaction videos. I'm thinking what I'm going to do for the next one is I'm going to ask you over on my Instagram at @BrianneWilliamson what your favorite TikToks are, and then I'll react to those. So make sure you're following me over there and watching my stories so you can see when that comes up. And until next time, thank you so much for watching. See you later, humans. Bye.